Hello, hello, I'm Li Hao. So let's talk about at debug. So this is a very useful tag in Svelte that allows you, that helps you to debug some of the data that you're using in your Svelte components. So let's take a look at an example and see how we can use this at debug tag in your Svelte components. So here I have a component that has a written array and a text, a value, right? So I loop through the array to render some input tag and also use an input to bind some value so that I can type on it. So as I type, yeah, you can see the data. You can't really see the data change unless you try to come over here and say value so that you know that you're actually updating the value. So when you type, you see that the value is changed. Maybe this is okay for you, but let me show you an alternative that you can use as well. Right? It does not mean that my alternative is better. It's just that more tools in your toolbox so that you can try and mix and match different kind of things that helps you to debug your application. So here, instead of using value, I can use add debug tag. So I say I will start with a curly brackets and say add debug. And then I can pass in any expressions that I want to debug. So here, if I say I want to debug the value, I will say add debug value. Immediately, you can see in the console, you see it's printing out an object with a value and the value of the value itself. So as I type, you sure enough, you can see that this value is updating. You see more things printing up in the console. And what's great about this is that if you try to inspect elements, which is when you try to open up your dev tools and when you try to type something, the debug tag itself also will set a debugger. So here you are breaking. So the Chrome dev tools will break at a point where we are printing out the value of this value, right? So here you can see that's how this value is being printed out, console.log value. And now you also can do things like getting this value and, you know, type out in the console, say what is the length, do something and check some of the things, right? So if you have some sort of complex object that you're trying to log over here, then this is very useful where you can like you don't have to manually set a breakpoint somewhere within your Svelte components. This will get triggered, will be tripped, and now you can open up console and check things like that, right? So let me close this and get out from the debugger. And I want to show you one more thing, right? So besides like using this debug value and like in a normal input value or things like that, okay, it doesn't have to be input value. You can come over here, have some reactively declared like double equals value plus value. You could also have double over here, right? So every time you change, you see double printed out double over here. So besides doing this at the top level, you could also have this debug tag somewhere in inside like each tag or if tag, each block or if block. Why is this useful? This is useful when you know, when you're trying to iterate through an array and you want to debug like a certain item inside the array and say like, I want to take a look at this item over here, right? I want to look at this, what all this item value is, right? So let me remove this debug. Okay, let me just comment this out. I want to debug what are the items available over here. And if I try to type something, you can see, you know, it will print out more. And I can say that, oh, this item value is 12, right? It will be useful for me when I have a breakpoint. I can break this at a particular item. But of course, you see that every time when I change something, I'm updating the array itself. So all this item is being updated. And too bad there's no way that you can just limit this debug in for a particular index. At least you can't do it this way. So a trick that I have is I can have each if block, if index goes to say, I just want to check the second one, which is index at 1, and print out this debug, right? So now when I change something else, it's not trip anything. Only when I you know what? I think this is a bug and I'll probably fix this. So if you're watching at this video, right now I'm using at version 38.2. This does not work, but I'll try to make it work in the future versions. And hopefully this will be very helpful that you just need to, you know, debug at a certain item and see it changes, right? So yeah, too bad I feel this is a bug. But anyway, hope that you learned something to use an add tag. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you have anything that you like to comment or ask about, comments down below. And as always, subscribe to my channel so that you get notified when the next one is out. So see ya, bye bye.